Well, we're out here at the 2019 Nats at Control Line Speed. I've got Carl Dodge with me, and he's going to tell us a little bit about something some folks may not know a whole lot about, and that's F2A. Carl, tell me, what is F2A and as it relates to Control Line Speed?
Well, to start with, F in FAI, the Federation of Aeronautics International, is for model planes, and F2 is control line model planes, and F2A is control line speed. Some fellows back in the 70s, I guess, began flying asymmetric airplanes, one wing and one tail surface, for a good reason. By eliminating surfaces extending out from the fuselage, you eliminate an element of drag that would otherwise be created by the twisting airstream from the prop touching these things. But then people started to think about that and make longer wings, and the wing has less drag than the two wires. And before, the wing length was limited to 1 meter, which is now standard, and everybody's airplane looks the same, incidentally, from the untrained eye. People were running 4, 5, maybe more length wings, and that was recognized to be a problem too for transportation purposes. If you're going to fly international competition and you have to maybe fly across an ocean, how do you transport a 6-foot wing? So right now they're limited to 1 meter, and most everyone, I would say everyone's airplane is built in a manner where the wing can be disassembled from the rest of it, making it much easier to transport in a compact box.
Well, Carl, thank you so much for taking a couple minutes to talk to us today and teaching us about F2A. I think this has been a fabulous education on something that I think a lot of people don't really know a whole lot about, and maybe hopefully they'll go out and try their hand at it someday.
It's not an easy sport to do, but we would certainly welcome some new faces. What I would encourage people to do is come out to a contest, talk to the people. Everyone will be happy to show you his equipment. There's no secrets. The stuff is not cheap either, but that's the way it is with any competitive sport that has grown to, you know, international status.
Well, as Carl said, all you got to do is go out to a contest to check some of this stuff out, and there's no doubt about it, you're going to get hooked pretty quick. One of the best contests you can come to is right here at the International Air Modeling Center. The National Air Modeling Championships happens every year right here in Muncie, Indiana, and this is the 2019 Nats. We're here at Control Line Speed, and Carl, thank you so much, and we are going to see you next time on the next Nats Demystified.